Fam, you know what time it is, Katana Garage in the building. Welcome back to part two of the 1986 MR2 Toyota build. In part one of the video, you'll notice that I installed the crankshaft as well as bearings, and I did not show torquing them down, but I did torque them in sequence and to spec at 44 foot-pounds in three steps. So I went 20, then I went 33, then I went 44 on the torque wrench. So now we have flipped the block over, and now I'm going to proceed to installing the pistons. Before you install the pistons, you want to make sure that you file each compression ring. And here are the compression rings. You got the top ring, the second ring, then you got the oil ring rails. All right. So I think to gap these, I think they get a gap to 40 thousandths of an inch. Yeah, 30, 20, I'm not sure. I think it was 40 thousandths of an inch, if I'm not mistaken. Anyway. Just consult your manual on that and the given specs on the vehicle, but I think it was 40 thousandths of an inch. Anyway, after you go ahead and file the ring end gaps, you want to go ahead and clock the rings. And what I mean clock, there's a certain way that you have to locate the gaps on each relief pocket of the piston itself. So if we flip the piston around with the notch indicating the forward front of the engine, this would be the intake relief ports and this would be the exhaust relief ports in this instance. What we're gonna do now is show you how to clock the rings respectively. So the first number one ring is gonna be over here by the left off the exhaust port, and so it's gonna look like this. So the gap is gonna be to the left right here. I don't know if you can see it. So there's a top ring at the bottom left of the intake port, the exhaust port. So the second ring is gonna be adjacent to the opposite side to the intake port. That's gonna be right intake port. Then the oil ring rail, the first side rail, is gonna be adjacent to the intake port on the left. And then the bottom oil ring rail, gonna be adjacent to the exhaust port on the bottom right. Now we're gonna go ahead, remove your connecting rod end cap, grab your microfiber and some brake parts cleaner, make sure you get any debris out of there, wipe that down nice and clean. This is gonna be my number one piston, so that's all clean. I'm gonna put a little dab of assembly lube on there, just a little dab, just like that. I'll go ahead and dab that in. I'm gonna rotate my crankshaft to where the journal comes up in the cylinder head, that way I can hit it nicely. So if you come with the camera, you can see where I have the journal. If you look down into the bore here, you'll see where I have the journal on the crankshaft pointing upwards as far this as I could possibly get it. Now, next step, I'm gonna go ahead, if you don't have the proper guards for the bolts and the connecting rod ends, you just use some rubber hosing. That's what I like to use. That way, the bolts don't come in contact with the journals. You don't wanna scratch the crank journal or anything like that. All right, so we're just gonna, before I do that, put in the wrong piston here. Then you wanna compress the rings on the piston. So this is a compression tool, a piston ring compression tool, and you just lock it over the piston and it will look like this when you compress it. So yeah, go ahead and put your guards back on, the connecting rod that you're about to assemble. Clean this one down. Put some assembly lube. Boom. And then make sure the skirt is protruding on the piston. I'm gonna gonna go ahead and lock it down some more. Okay, make sure the skirt of the piston is completely out, because this is how we're gonna get it down into the bore. This is how I like to do it. So I got the skirt, I could see it. Now make sure your piston is facing forwards, all your rings are clocked and ready to go. All right, here we go. Just match up your connecting rod end cap. Make sure it's the right end cap. Good to go. So you're just gonna guide it down into the bore. Wait, before that, I like to put a little bit of oil. Some people don't like to do that, but I like to do that just to lube it up. My bore is nice and clean already. Give it just a little dab, nothing too crazy. You know what I mean? All right, slap this baby in. Piston facing forwards, we're at number one cylinder. Here we go. Slide it down. Now you're gonna have it seated. And you can see how the piston is seated right there. Nice and perfect. I've verified that the connecting rod's ends are gonna come right over the crank. So now I'm just gonna go on and get my mallet and tap it in. Or you can just use the wood end on your hammer. The wood end is pretty soft. And just tap it in. Here we go, nice and firm. Just like that. That's how you install a piston. You go ahead and flip the block around so you can install the connecting rod end cap. Hold the piston because you don't want it falling. I tell you that. This is how I like to do it. So if you come down here with the camera, you will see what I mean about the blocking, like the guards on the connecting rods. This is why I like to use the machine here. Yeah, this is why I like to use these rubber guards so that it doesn't come in contact with the connecting rod, with the crank journal. So, and remove those. Like that. Then I like to rotate the crank a little bit.
Check my Harley dashboard. I do the dashboard, gas to the floor. I'm pressing fast forward. I race an ass car. Transport, this what you ask for. Don't ask me what I ask for. If you can't answer, now who does answer? I pop dance for muscle relaxation. I'm a patient. Pick up the pace when I feel too adjacent to who I'm racing. Yeah, I'm spacing. I'm spacing out. Oh, you faded. I'm faded out. Oh, you made it. I made it out. But you shit it like 8 mile, 8 ball. For running, I'm laying down. I'm laying down like an eagle. I'm only one in the game, I'm inside of you, I'm not young man.